So today we are going to start electrical maintenance, and your first chapter is symbols used in electrical units. So basically, why we need to learn symbols or why we need to understand symbols. So if we know the symbols, then we can read the circuit, electrical circuit, or we can draw the circuit. If we are not able to understand the symbols, then we are not able to read the circuit diagram which will be provided. So it's very important, and the first rule that we must know the symbols. Starting from the basic, this is positive and negative terminals which we denote in the circuit. This is the cell. Cell is basically a device which converts chemical energy into electrical energy. And symbol is this. It has two terminals, positive and negative. The terminal which is long is positive and which is small is negative. So we have to keep in mind that it has two terminals and we have to connect it accordingly. Battery. So battery is nothing but group of cells. So its symbol is like this. It's a group of cells, and it also has positive terminal and negative terminal. DC supply, DC current. So DC supply is denoted by a single line, or simply we can write DC in the circle. So this denotes the DC supply. Why we write the single line or draw the single line? This is because in DC, electric charge only flows in one direction. So it is like single straight line. In AC supply, we use a sine wave because it's alternating. Wherever there is fault in our circuit, then we can denote it by this symbol. Earthing. We all know we have to do earthing, and this is the symbol for earthing. Lamp. Whenever we have to connect the lamp in the circuit, then we have to use this symbol. Resistance. This is a fixed resistance and this is variable resistance. When the term variable comes, then we have to just add this arrow. Fixed capacitor, variable capacitor. Inductive coil. So this is the symbol of inductive coil. Moving further to the switches. So this is one way switch. This switch is used commonly, or this is a simple switch which operates when the switch is on, then our bulb or anything which is in output will be in circuit. This is a two-way switch. This switch can operate single lamp from two different locations. That means we can operate single lamp from different locations. If consider the case of staircase. This is the staircase and we have bulb here. If the person is here, or we can say downwards, downstairs, and he glows the lamp from here, and when he reaches up and he will just turn off the lights coming upstairs. So this is called a two-way switch. So this is bulb which is controlled from here and here from different locations. ICTP switch. This is iron clad triple pole switch. It is three fuse arrangement. So this is basically used where three phase is required. So pendant switch. This switch is used to control the lamps or other devices that are mounted overhead beyond the reach of person. So these are used there, and this is the symbol of pendant switch. This is a fuse. Fuse is used to protect the overcurrent flow through it. So the main component of a fuse is a metal wire which melts when the overcurrent flows through it. So this is simply a safety device. DC voltmeter. So basically, when the terms DC comes, then we have to draw a straight line, and it is saying that it is voltmeter. So we have to write just V, and this is our voltmeter, DC voltmeter symbol. Similarly, AC voltmeter. So this is the sign for AC. This is sine wave, and then voltmeter. So DC AC voltmeter, then both are included here. DC AC wattmeter. So we have to write here W, and this is the symbol of wattmeter. DC generator. When the term generator comes, we have to give here or write here G. That means generator, and this is DC. AC generator, AC for this sine wave, and this is generator. DC motor, AC motor, and choke. This is the symbol of choke. Choke is used to block the high frequencies passing through the DC and low frequencies through the AC. So we'll see further. Transformer. So basically we know the construction of transformer and working. So transformer has two windings and this is the symbol of transformer. Whenever we have to draw or include the transformer in circuit, then this is the symbol which we use. Auto transformer, it has a single winding, so we have mentioned here single winding. Frequency meter, this is frequency meter, so frequency F, and we have here written F. This is frequency meter. Power factor meter, this is phi. Bell and buzzer, these are the symbols for bell and buzzer. This is the bell symbol and this is the buzzer symbol. Relay. So relay is electromagnetic switch which is used to turn on or off circuit by a low power signal. So this is the symbol of relay. A bracket fan, this is the symbol. A ceiling fan, this is the symbol. And exhaust fan, DC series motor. So as I said earlier, DC, so we have to draw one straight line. And then motor, so this is here M and this is the symbol of DC series motor. DC series generator, this is the symbol. Single phase squirrel cage induction motor. Single phase, this which indicates it is single phase. And this is motor, squirrel cage induction motor. Three phase squirrel cage induction motor, this indicates three phase. So this is the slip ring motor. So this is the symbol of three phase slip ring motor. So if you have to remember the symbols, then first what you have to do is practice and just remember the symbols according to their names. So now we'll move further and see the symbols of main and distribution fuse board as per ISI. So how we have to understand or remember these symbols? Just look at these symbols and these symbols. These are quite similar, but difference is one, just they have lines and this is completely dark. So yeah, main fuse board without switches, lightings, this is the symbol. And distribution fuse board without switches, lighting, this is the symbol. Just compare and remember the symbols. Main fuse board with switches and lighting, this is the symbol. Distribution fuse board with sketches, lightings, this is the symbol. Main fuse board without switches, power, this is the symbol. Distribution fuse board without switches, power, this is the symbol. Main fuse board with switches, power, this is the symbol. Distribution fuse board with switches, power, this is the symbol. Just we have to consider the difference and then remember the symbols accordingly. So this is the main trick to remember the symbols. Main switches, lighting, so this is the symbol and we have to write here L. Main switches, power, this is the symbol and we have to write here P. And meter, meter symbol is this. And control board, this is the symbol. Okay. If you have any doubts, I guess there will be no doubt because these are all symbols and we have to remember these symbols. So yeah. If you have any doubts, I will share the PDF on your group.